The new TV 52, KFWA-TV, Fort Worth, Dallas, your entertainment getaway.
Live from the Fort Worth Convention Center in Fort Worth, Texas, it's Central Hockey League action. Tonight, the Fort Worth Brahmas and the Austin Ice Baths. Tonight's Fort Worth Brahmas hockey game on KFWD Channel 52 is brought to you by Chevrolet, the official vehicle of the Fort Worth Brahmas. Chevy will be there. And Coors Beer, the official beer of the Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey Club. And by Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. And also by Washington Mutual Bank, the official bank of the Fort Worth Brahmas. Everybody, I'm Mike Barrick, the general manager of the team, tonight's play-by-play voice, and with me is the Brahmas director of public relations, Jeff Bowerman. We are in for some excitement tonight as the Brahmas take on the Ice Bats, looking to clinch a playoff spot.
Mike, it's going to be an exciting hockey game. Two of the best teams in the Central Hockey League. Austin's leading the Southeast Division. The Fort Worth Brahmas have won six out of their last seven to move to third overall in the Northern Conference, looking for their first playoff berth in 3 years, so it should be exciting, should be a lot of fun. It's going to be a great hockey game tonight here at the Convention Center.
Well, let's take a look at the Northern Conference standings, and currently Fort Worth sitting third overall, 5 points ahead of Tulsa and Shreveport, looking to clinch.
Yeah, Fort Worth with that six-game winning streak really solidified their spot in the standings. They went from out of the playoff picture to on top of both Bossier, Shreveport, and Tulsa by 5 points. So if the Brahmas can pick up a win tonight, as well as a couple wins next week, should be looking good as far as playoff-wise goes. But it's going to be a great battle.
And in the Southern Conference, Austin and Odessa are battling for 1-2. The Ice Bats, one of the toughest teams in the Central Hockey League.
Yeah, Austin's been a great team all season long. They've raced out to a 39-15-5 record. They got 83 points on the season. San Antonio's right on their heels, but if Austin can get a couple wins, they're going to really solidify themselves in that two spot, and they'll have the all-important home ice advantage in that first round. It's going to be a great battle. Also, keep in mind that El Paso is leading Lubbock by just 3 points, New Mexico by just 3 points for that fourth and final spot, so keep your eyes on that race as we go down the final week of the regular season.
And of course, tonight, a lot of players to watch for the Brahmas. This guy has been terrific. The offensive leader, Joe Van Volsen.
Yeah, Joe Van Volsen, what can you say about Smoking Joe? I mean, jump on his back is what he's saying to the boys in the room before the game. He's got, last 10 games, 6 goals, 8 assists, 21 goals, 41 assists on the season. He's the Brahmas' leading scorer. He's a quiet assassin. The minute you take your eyes off him, he's going to put the puck in the back of the net. He's, in my mind, one of the top 5 players in the Central Hockey League, and he's having a great year for Fort Worth.
And the Brahmas are going to have to watch out to the Austin Ice Bats, a very dangerous offensive team led by the gentleman who's tied for the scoring lead in the Central Hockey League.
Brett Sagan, 87 points. He's got soft hands. I mean, his hands are softer than his baby's backside. So, I mean, he can set you up. He can score goals. And he's got two wingers that he's playing with in Price and Tulare that can put the puck in the back of the net quickly. So, what if the Brahmas are going to win tonight, they're going to need to control Sagan and keep Price and Tulare from finding opportunities to score.
And tonight should be exciting. The Brahmas expect one of their largest crowds in franchise history. And why not? New Jersey night, the kids and families are out. Brahmas looking to clinch a playoff spot. Should be extremely exciting tonight.
Let's get her going, Mike. I'm jumping around here in the booth. I'm fired up, ready to drop the puck and get after it.
Well, tonight, the Brahmas and the Ice Bats coming up, the play-by-play in just a moment. Fort Worth Brahmas hockey on Channel 52.
What happens to most beer right after it's packaged? It gets heated, often up to 140 degrees, but not at Coors. Our beers are filtered cold, packaged cold, and shipped cold. All beers are not alike. That's no boast, just a cold fact.
All that glitters is gold. It shines through in every one of our dependable, long-lasting Chevy trucks. It's Truck Month. Now get 0% APR on any Chevy Silverado. Or get $2,002 cash back on a Silverado regular cab. That's 0% APR on all new Silverados or $2,002 cash back on Silverado regular cab. Only offers this good on trucks this durable. Get the gold bow tie. It's Truck Month. See your Texas Chevy dealer now.
You know what people are saying about you guys? That you're a bunch of vicious animals. Well, you and I know that's not true. You and I know this is a game of skill and precision. and speed and grace. So I want you to go out there tonight and show them what Fort Worth Brahmas hockey is really about. Okay, you can open the cage now.
Another Shaqcessory story.
For years, people have looked for hard-to-find batteries everywhere, from drugstores to grocery stores. But people in the know the place is Radio Shack. Get your hard-to-find batteries for your electronics, no matter where you bought them, from camcorders to cordless phones. Even cordless shavers. Right, Ving? I'll demonstrate. Mohawk?
Radio Shack has hard-to-find batteries for thousands of products.
Did she finish?
Radio Shack.
Hi, I just want to make a deposit.
You have your account number?
Right here.
Lean forward, please.
What is this?
It's our new customer tracking system. It has your account number and barcode. It speeds you right through the line.
Now what?
That line over there.
Feel like banks are getting a bit impersonal? Try Washington Mutual. We're building our bank around you because we never forget it's your money.
What's a holdup?
I hate it when these things don't scan.
Washington Mutual.
Welcome back to the Fort Worth Convention Center. Tonight, the Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats. A great crowd tonight, and we should be in for a lot of excitement. Fort Worth, as mentioned, with a victory tonight, can almost solidify their playoff spot. And, of course, the Ice Bats have been in the playoffs for a while, Jeff, but they are a very, very dangerous opponent.
Yeah, it's a tale of two teams that are both after the same goal, the President's Cup. The Ice Bats have been chasing it all season long. They've been one of the top teams overall in the league all year long, right from the get-go. The Brahmas kind of started out real fast, hit a little bump in the road mid-season, but are really turning it on late as of the second half here. They've won 6 out of the last 7, 7 out of the last 10. They're peaking at the right time, and the Brahmas, Mike, as we'll get into over the course of the broadcast, are looking for their first playoff berth in 3 seasons. So it's a critical game for each team. Austin, they're trying to hang on to that Southeast Division lead. The Brahmas trying to hold on to that third spot and stay ahead of Bossier Shreveport in Tulsa. So basically, Mike, this one's a playoff game. I expect playoff intensity. Got a great atmosphere tonight at the Convention Center, and should be exciting hockey.
Well, let's take a look at the Coors starting lineups. Tonight's starting lineups are brought to you by Coors, the official beer of the Fort Worth Brahmas.
First, looking at the visiting Austin Ice Bats, dressed in their white sweaters tonight. Up front, number 7, Kelly Smart. On a wing is number 10, Bobby Brown. Brown, of course, spent a good part of the season with the Houston Aeros of the American Hockey League. He's a super, super talented player. He's dangerous from any spot on the ice, so he's one the Brahmas are definitely going to have to watch. Also up front for the Ice Bats, big center, number 26, Jeff Greenlaw. Greenlaw, of course, an ex-NHL player, played with both the Florida Panthers and the Washington Capitals. Great size in front of the net. On defense for the Ice Bats, number 22, Daryl MacArthur, and also on the back end, number 16, Mike Gaffney. For your Brahmas up front, let's go with number 10, Sean Hughes. Hughes on the wing. Peter Campbell, number 14, had a hat trick on Wednesday against Indy. He's centering. Right side, number 28, Jason Clark. On defense for the Brahmas, number 3, Adam Davis, and number 4, Dave Bork.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
job of our national anthem here at the Fort Worth Convention Center. The Brahmas with a record of 17-9-2 at home, 29-23-7 overall. And a look from behind the net, we'll see a couple of goaltenders here tonight that have had stellar seasons, both for the Fort Worth Brahmas and for the Austin Ice Bats. And Jeff, the goaltenders, as mentioned, have been terrific for both Fort Worth and for Austin.
The goaltender is going to play a major part in the story for tonight for the Brahmas. Specifically in net is Super Cooper, number 29, Corey Cooper. Cooper with 27 wins on the season, 21 losses. He leads the CHL in saves with 1,730, second in minutes. He's been a workhorse all season long for the Brahmas, 56 starts and 59 games so far for Fort Worth. Turning our attention to Brian McMullen for Austin, the other starting all-star goaltender. McMullen's 27-7-3 overall. He's got a 2.37 goals against average. That's third in the league, and a .917 save percentage. So McMullen definitely, if not as good as Cooper, capable of carrying the load for the Ice Bats. These two goaltenders, Mike, the opposing starters in the All-Star game back in Corpus Christi in February. So we got an All-Star cast in net, and they'll definitely play a big part in the hockey game.
Well, as mentioned, he has been a workhorse also in the 39 games this year, a 2.57 goals against in a fifth-year pro. It's a look from the back of the Austin goal at the Fort Worth Convention Center. There's the U.S. flag. There will be a tremendous crowd, perhaps the largest in Brahma's history, on our youth jersey night. And, Jeff, a lot of the families and kids, as you can take a look, a family atmosphere here at the Convention Center.
Yeah, they all came out for those youth jerseys. Radio Disney, KSCS 96.3. Put their names on the back of the jerseys. Great giveaway, Adam, and it's good to see this building full, and I expect to be rocking all night long.
Brahmas in the first period will be going from left to right. The referee is Gordy Dwyer. Brian Bull and Doug Wittig are the linesmen. Fort Worth looking for their 18th win of the season at home. Their 30th of the season, looking for points number 66 and 67. Up front, Peter Campbell, and here we go against Kelly Smart. An immediate the Brahmas clear it in to the Austin zone. The Brahmas have won just one game this season against the Bats. 1-4-2, outscored 26-15. And back at his own side is Adam Davis for Fort Worth. Along the near board for Dave Bork, clears to center, and the Bats just clear it right back into the Fort Worth zone of the Brahmas control.
Watch each team try to kind of feel each other out over the first couple minutes of this hockey, and you'll see a lot of dump and chase. Fort Worth without some key players tonight, just 13 skaters, so the Brahmas going to play a lot of defense tonight and try to be opportunistic offensively.
Young defenseman Gaffney check. Brahmas in front. Hughes is shot, and I believe McMullen got a piece of that. It's cleared away, and Kelly Smart breaks out the other way for Austin, clears it in. Cooper back the other way, plays for Jason Clark. A long slap shot off the backboards and wide. The teams change up. Hughes in a forecheck, and the Bats come up with it in a center ice. Just underway. Glad you joined us tonight. Channel 52, the Brahmas' first broadcast on KFWD-TV. We're excited about that and glad you've joined us here tonight. Ice Bats in their white uniforms trying to clear at the center, and they bang it right back into the Fort Worth zone. Cooper himself likes to play the puck and does to center ice.
Yeah, you'll watch Cooper do that all night long. He's like having a third defenseman back there. He can move the puck probably better than some of our defensemen, but he can really set up other players to start the breakout.
Cooper just turned 25 years of age, and the Brahmas control Van Volsen. Deep pass up the middle, and it's a two-line offside from inside the Fort Worth blue line to the Austin side of center ice.
Todd Ballon has to be happy about his start for the Brahmas. Sean Hughes with a scoring chance moments ago. Bottom of the right side, great centering pass from Peter Campbell. Hughes didn't quite get all on that shot that he wanted to. McMullen was ready for the save, but there was a rebound opportunity. That's one of McMullen's tendencies. He gives up some fat rebounds, so if the Brahmas can get the puck on net, they should have some follow-up opportunities.
Faceoff will be just inside the line. Peter Kava, who joined the Brahmas earlier this season. Jason Clark on the right wing side. Fort Worth, again, one victory this season against the Bats. Also on the left wing side for Fort Worth, Craig Johnson, who can play forward and defense. A clearing shot to center ice and back after Bork for Fort Worth. Plays it free into the center ice area, and the Bats control at their own blue line. And it is Greg Willard, the defenseman, plays to center. And a chance for Tab Leitner into the Fort Worth zone. The youngster centers block right through the goal crease. Nobody home. The Brahmas try to clear it out. Can't. Bats keep tip it in back behind the Fort Worth goal. And Sumac to the Bahamas, clears to the blue line. But big Craig Johnson for Fort Worth plays to center, and the bats just clear it right back in on right wing.
Yeah, this third line for Austin, LaRocque, Lardner, and Anderson, they played well against Fort Worth last week up here, and look for Brent Hughes to give them some extended ice time here tonight.
Brent Hughes is the Austin coach. We'll take a look at Brent as the night progresses. Greg Rillers now for Austin. Plays to center ice, and the bats on the attack. This is their big line as Smart able to clear it in on offside with 17:36 left in the opening period. No score. The faceoff will be in the neutral zone. A look at young Willers, a 22-year-old defenseman out of Aurora, Ontario, third-year pro. And they have kind of a good combination on Austin of youngsters and veterans.
Yeah, Austin has an affiliation with the Houston Aeros of the American Hockey League. They get players from time to time assigned to them by Houston. Bobby Brown is one. Willers is another one. That really adds to their depth of talent on the Austin roster.
And the Ice Bats with a whopping 83 points this year cleared into the Fort Worth zone. And the Brahmas control back of the net. Adam Davis for the Brahmas on the right wing side for Bork. They're the defensive pairing on this unit. Plays to center ice and a chance for Van Volsen, the leading scorer for Fort Worth. In centers. Oh, and a save by McMullen on the great centering pass to Brent Culleton, and he was robbed.
What a save by McMullen. Write that one down. McMullen makes the first big save of the hockey game. But there's the offense from Van Volsen that we were talking about in the open.
And a play to center ice and Smart for Austin. Spanks it right back into the Fort Worth zone. Ice bats in deep to forecheck. No score. First period. Brahmas with the best scoring chance, however. And Fort Worth gained possession at their own defense. And here comes Culleton in for Fort Worth. Left wing side pass across the line. Chance for Willard. Centers one right through the goal crease for Campbell. And finally, it's broken up with the Austin defense and wound to center. Big hit over there into the Austin zone.
Yeah, Willard just lit up Tulare. And that's how you got to play Gerald Tulare. He's a fast player, but he's smallish. And the Brahmas' bigger forwards can look to take it to him all night long.
Ice Bats control at their own defense. A clearing pass intercepted. Culleton steals. He shoots high over top of the net. Great scoring chance for Fort Worth's Culleton. The Ice Bats clear it down the ice. We should have an icing. Hughes is dead. Barely wins the battle. Icing is the call here in the first period. No scores. 16-13 left in the opening frame. And the let's take a look at that last scoring chance for Fort Worth. Great setup in front.
Yeah, it was a turnover by Austin in their own end. Culleton gloved it down, looked to pass, but then he went ahead and shot it just wide. He tried to go high stick on McMullen. McMullen goes down real early. Culleton waited, had McMullen commit, just couldn't get it on net. But that's a great chance for the Brahmas. That's the kind of opportunities they're going to need playing with just 13 skaters tonight.
McMullen is large, 6'2", 195 pounds.
He'll make you shoot wide.
Here's Tilson, right point, slap shot, kicked aside, rebound in front, wide. The net is actually off its moorings as McMullen was down and out into the Austin goal crease. And the Brahmas continue to pepper McMullen, who is in his 40th game of the season. You mentioned a lot of activity in front of the goal. If he goes down, that could open, obviously, some room up top.
A player like his size, he's been taught early to go down and use his frame to take up space in the net. And you'll see the Brahmas players try to pick and choose their spots, maybe a little too fine. That might have been what Culleton did a moment ago. He tried to pick that very top corner of the net, shot it just wide, but Fort Worth's off to a great start, Mike. They're all over the Ice Bats early.
Van Volsen and Woolert and Culleton. So far, the Brahmas three shots on goal. The Ice Bats have yet to register a shot officially on Corey Cooper. And it's cleared right back into the Fort Worth zone. Sumrick for the Brahmas checked off in the play. Eric LaBelle, a rookie, tries to work it in front. Cooper, the save on Tab Lardner, also a youngster, a rookie in this league. And the Brahmas clear it right back in, so Cooper tested in the slot.
Big save by Cooper. He's into the game now.
Here's a play now on the center ice. No score. First period, LaRocque clears it right back in. There have been no power plays so far, no penalties, and a total of four shots on goal. And two of those have been terrific scoring chances, one for both the Brahmas and the Ice Bats. Here's Davis on left wing, trying to clear it through to the blue line, pokes it to center, and the Ice Bats, LaRocque, drops it free. 15-11 left first period. No score from the Fort Worth Convention Center. Central Hockey League action. The Brahmas and the Bats from Austin. Here's Sumrick near corner. Tries to work it free to Culleton. Stolen by Smart on his backhand. Shoots blocked by Davis. Rebound. Greenlaw in front.
Oh my gosh!
Unbelievable save on Jeff Greenlaw!
Are you kidding me? What a glove save by Cooper. Cooper went down early. Greenlaw had the backhand. Kind of rolled on him a little bit, but he went up high, and Cooper was able to throw the glove up. Big save by Corey Cooper. That's why he is the Brahmas' go-to guy in net.
We'll take a look at the bit. No score. Brahmas and the Ice Bats on KFWD TV 52.
Today we're going to be doing some real home cooking. Main course is
brick
from my very own home, in fact. And we'll just give it a taste. Bit stiff. Boost the heat a little bit.
For real home cooking taste, come in during Sonic's Home Cooking Month. Sonic's the only place to get the down-home flavor of our new Country Fried Steak Toaster Sandwich. Try one today, or any of our other toaster sandwiches.
Next, Spackle Casserole.
Get any large drink in our new car cup in any flavor you can dream of, now just 99 cents.
Action, and how about this save by Corey Cooper on the ice bats, Jeff Greenlaw.
Yeah, Greenlaw's a big player, and he takes up a lot of space between the circles there. That loose puck just kind of found him. He had it on his forehand. He tried to go high, and Cooper just threw up the quick glove. That's where goals go to die here, the Fort Worth Convention Center. Corey Cooper's big glove. That's a huge save for the Brahmas. Cooper keeps it scoreless.
Cooper, more minutes, more shots against, more saves than any other netminder in the Central Hockey League, and still has a sparkling 3.11 goals against average. Brahmas play it free on the left wing side. Sean Hughes for Jason Clark, and he spins it into the neutral zone, and the Ice Bats gain possession. 14 and a half minutes left, first period. Great crowd here in Fort Worth as the Brahmas and the Bats from the convention center. Austin play at the center ice. Clark steals, and a stoppage of play. It looks like our first penalty on the play on the far side.
Looks like it's going to be a rough on Adam Davis. Davis coming in high on the Ice Bats player. I believe that was LaBelle on the far side. Davis kind of leading with his that was Brownlee for Austin coming up that right side, and Davis hit Brownlee from behind. And the reason they called that a roughing penalty, Mike, was because Brownlee was within 3 feet of the boards. He wasn't facing the player. That's an automatic call for referee Gordy Dwyer, and that's a penalty that Davis, I'm sure, would want back. But you got to like his aggression, the young rookie.
He has played terrific for Fort Worth. Last year played in the North American Hockey League with the Texas Tornado. The Brahmas on the penalty kill this year fared okay. 59 for 315. They ranked ninth in the league at 81%. The Ice Bats number one, 51 on the power plays for 222, 22.9%. That's best in the league.
Yeah, Austin's dangerous with weapons like Sagan, Tallaire, Price, and Brown. They don't need any help, specifically not an extra man. So let's see if this is a big kill for Fort Worth early.
Here's Tallaire on the right wing side for the Ice Bats. Back of the goal, the forward Price tries to center one, but Mike Tilson, a third-year Brahma defenseman, plays it free to the near side, and Clark able to wind it right back to center ice and deep into the Ice Bat zone.
Big kill for Fort Worth here. As they are undermanned, that first goal is pivotal tonight, and the Brahmas need to kill this one off and kind of get some confidence, get entrenched defensively.
Here is Tilson for the Brahmas. Leaves it free. The Brahmas clear but not out. At the right point, a shot. Cooper, the save. Daniel Tetro let it fly from the right point. There were two Austin players in vicinity, and Cooper says no.
Cooper, the big save on Tetro. Tetro's a very, very, very skilled defenseman. In fact, I voted for him for Outstanding Defenseman of the Year. He got a shot from straight away there, right side. A low, hard shot from the point. Good work by Johnson in front to clear out any traffic. Allowed Cooper to see that one all the way and made the glove save. I like Craig Johnson's aggressiveness in front of the net. That's the kind of message you need to send to Austin, is you stay away from the crease and keep out of the way of Corey Cooper.
The Ice Bats, as mentioned, a dangerous power play unit. Fort Worth trying to clear it free, and they succeed. So twice they've just immediately cleared it into the Austin territory.
Faceoffs are the key, Mike. That was a key defensive zone faceoff win by Peter Cava for the Brahmas.
Here's Willers, the defenseman for the Bats, clears it right back into the Fort Worth territory. It bounces on edge like a beach ball. In the work of play, Smart now for the Bats. in deep to try to make a play. There are four players in the scrum. Finally, it squirts free, and the Brahmas break two men to center. Here comes Cobb on his off wing. In across the line, now tries to split the defense poke check, but a great play by Fort Worth and McMullen, and a Fort Worth player, Willard, collide. A penalty coming up, I think, against Fort Worth. Greenlaw hit on the play by Kava. It's loose. There's a delayed penalty, an empty net, a chance for the Ice Bats. Saved by Cooper on the shot by Greg Willers on the empty net with the sixth attacker. And now pushing and shoving in front of the net with Greenlaw and Dan Villeneuve, who's no stranger to the penalty box as well. Greenlaw, former Washington Capital, and...
Yeah, Greenlaw, Villeneuve, eye to eye there, and then you can trust they're not exchanging Easter greetings.
Right.
But Greenlaw's not afraid, and you got to respect Dan Villeneuve. He's a veteran defenseman for the Brahmas. He'll get in somebody's face and send a message. The penalty coming up here, Mike, is going to be a goaltender interference call to Chad Willard. Willard was just cruising down that right side. Didn't mean to run into Brian McMullen. McMullen, if we can get a replay here, we'll see that momentarily. But McMullen was at top of his crease. And as Willard crossed in front of the crease, his legs became tangled with McMullen. That's a goaltender interference penalty on Willard. And the Brahmas are going to be down two men for the next 22 seconds.
Let's take a look at this upcoming. And there's the end result, the spill. But here's the beginning of that play.
Yeah, Cava coming through neutral ice there. Made one move too many there at the blue line. Kind of got the puck stuck in his skates. Willard was crashing the net looking for a shot. And you'll see him screaming down that right side. As McMullen stood up, he kind of came out of the edge of his crease, and that's why Lalonde is displeased with his call. He's got referee Dwyer over by the Brahmas bench now, and he's saying if McMullen's going to come out of the crease and be aggressive, he's fair game, and that's Lalonde's argument right now. But nonetheless, Willard to the box, two for goaltender interference, and the Brahmas down two men. And for the next 22 seconds, Mike, this could be a pivotal time in the game early. This faceoff is key here. Look for Van Bolson to take the draw for the Brahmas.
This is not what Todd Lalonde wants, noting Fort Worth started the game with 13 skaters, two men in the box, but immediately they get the draw. Beautiful off the faceoff.
Smoking Joe right on cue.
That was Van Volsen. Here's the play on the right wing side. Five on three for 13 seconds now. Here's Bobby Brown, very dangerous in front. Shoots one, Cooper, a save, rebound. And it's the net is knocked off its moorings as the right post is off. And the Bats had a couple of cracks at it, but Cooper held that goal crease area and kept the puck out of the net.
Good work by Cooper in net for the Brahmas. He had to move post to post there across the crease. The first shot came from the right side here. We'll take a look at it on the replay. That was Sagan down low, right side, bottom of the circle. Cooper stood tall. The rebound came over to LaRocque down low on the left side, and Cooper was able to slide post to post, slam those leg pads together, and keep it out.
Here's play at the point, Tetro. Now between the circles, leaves it free. First player, Davis, is back on. It's now a one-man power play. Brown, right point, Tetro shoots, caught by Corey Cooper. Tetro let it fly from the left point. He's a 22-year-old from Manitoba, and Cooper saw it all the way. That's what you want. There was no screen in front as we take a look on that last scoring opportunity.
Well, really, that's what both teams want. You want to give Tetro the shot from the point, but the Brahmas did a good job of keeping that area in front of the crease clear of traffic, and Cooper's aggressive, Mike. You'll notice when he's on his game, he's aggressive. He's out of the crease. He's got that head bobbing, the glove moving around. That's a good save for Cooper off a good shot by Tetro.
Here's play at the right point. The Ice Bats try and work it free, but the Brahmas intercept at the defense. Bork just clears it down. No relation to Ray Bork, but Dave has played well on the back line for Fort Worth.
Yeah, I've been trying to explain to people all year that he's not Bork's brother, but I just hope he plays like him a little bit. But he's been really good over the last couple months of the season for Fort Worth. He's going to be key down the stretch for the Brahmas.
And he is more of a defensive player than an offensive threat, but he still plays very well on defense for the Fort Worth Brahmas. Here's Tolaire up the center ice, leaves it free into the Fort Worth zone, but the Brahmas back checking, intercept, and beautifully just poke it, Campbell, all the way down into the Austin zone.
Good penalty killing by the Brahmas. Not to kind of clogging things up, neutral ice, not allowing Austin to get set up.
Here's a play to the blue line, no score, first period, 11:31 left in the first, 40 seconds left in the penalty. And the Ice Bats work it free in a two-man rush on this power play. They set it up on the far boards. Ian LaRocque tries to jam it loose, a mad scramble. It's clear to the left wing point. Ice Bats now play to the right point as the Brahmas keep them on the perimeter. Austin trying to work it in front, play to the right wing point. Yank Girdle on the far side, back of the net. Ian LaRocque tries to dump it in front of backhand. Right for the goal crease, nobody home. Willers paws it down and a stop again, the net dislodge. That's actually been fortunate for a fortunate situation for the Brahmas, with the ice bats buzzing into the zone, into the forward territory, down to 13 seconds left in that penalty.
Well, when that net goes off the moorings, Mike, that gives the Brahmas a good 30, 45 seconds to catch their breath. And as we've stated a couple times in the broadcast, forwards with just 13 skaters tonight. Cardwell, Leibel out with injury, Bateman on assignment. So the Brahmas a little bit undermanned. They'll take all the extra stoppages they can get. And Mike, we need to talk about the big captain out there, Craig Johnson. What a shift for him killing this penalty. He's throwing about three or four good hits along the wall. And Craig, he's a physically imposing guy. He can scare guys. And we need him to play aggressive like this throughout the course of the game.
No score, 11 minutes left in the first. Brahmas clear at the center. That's down to 10 seconds left in the penalty. Curling around is Dominic Perriar, a defenseman. 4 seconds left, that's gonna do it on the penalty. And back on for Fort Worth, Chad Willard. The Brahmas kill off a two-man power play, and Willard steals. Right side, Van Volsen, in across the line. He pulls up, centers for Willard, but broken up in the ice bats, break the center. Into the Fort Worth zone, Gerald Tolaire broken up at the Fort Worth blue line. And Johnson winds to center, Campbell steals and dumps it to the Austin defense.
Good defensive move by Johnson on the poke check. Tolaire's a speedy guy, but Johnson was able to use his long reach, poke the puck off Tolaire's stick.
And the Ice Bats control, 10-20, left first period. No score from the convention center in Fort Worth, Texas. That's right, hockey over here in Cowtown as the Brahmas take on the Bats. Lead pass to center for Campbell, broken up, and then Austin just cleared right back in. So play from blue line to blue line, the Bats change on the fly.
Yeah, Fort Worth with a great kill moments ago. Now they need to get a little offense there, take advantage of the momentum that they picked up from killing off that two-man advantage by the Bats.
Here's Dan Volanov in his second stint for Fort Worth, clears it free and across the line, and then the Ice Bats wind it deep into Fort Worth territory. This should be an icing. 9:46 left, first period, no score, and we'll take a break. No score, you're watching Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey.
It's the grand opening of the all-new Galaxy Furniture Warehouse with out-of-this-world prices throughout the store. Living room group, 7 pieces, $299. Dining room starting at $129. And bedroom suites starting at $388 for 5 pieces. Special financing and Visa, MasterCard, and Discover accepted.
Save at both locations.
The Galaxy Furniture Warehouse Grand Opening Sale. 950 Big Town Shopping Center, Mesquite, and 2424 South Buckner Boulevard, Dallas.
Mike Barrick and Jeff Bowerman from the Convention Center. No score, Brahmas and the Bats. Folks, don't forget, visit the Brahmas website at brahmas.com for the latest in Brahmas information. That's www.brahmas.com, the official website of the Fort Worth Brahmas. Jeff Bowerman, you're involved with that. Lots of information and tidbits on that website.
We try to keep it as current as possible. If you're online, check out our site, catch up on all the action with the Brahmas, and there's some great photos on there. You get to see the background of the players, and it's a great source of information for your Brahmas. If you haven't checked it out, please do.
Face-off will be into the Austin zone, the puck loose to the near side, and then wound up to center ice. The Ice Bats clear it right back in. Sumerick back after for the Brahmas. He is checked. Mad scramble back behind the Fort Worth goal. Hustling after it is Ryan Anderson. They try and work it for LaRocque, but broken up on the far wing for Jason Clark. He clears net out, stolen by Lardner. His shot caught by Cooper. The fortunate thing for Fort Worth, the Ice Bat shots are from long range, and Cooper is able to see the shot all the way through.
That's a bad turnover for Fort Worth on the right side. Clark with a giveaway. It led to a shot from straightaway by Lardner, but there's Cooper on top of his crease. He's aggressive, he's square to the puck. His technique's really sound right now, and he's got a ton of confidence coming off the Goaltender of the Week award that Cooper won last week for Fort Worth. He won 4 games, 4-0 overall, so he's got a lot of confidence back there. He's full of vim, vigor, and energy, and he's playing like it early.
He's a fifth-year pro, played junior hockey in the Ontario Hockey League with the Belleville Bulls. Here's the play now into the corner, into the Fort Worth zone. Ice Bats in possession for the moment. Wooler trying to steal. Brahma's clear to the blue line, held in the slot area. And the Ice Bats, Big Greenlaw, centers in front of the goal. Chance for the Ice Bats. Brown, check, cleared, not out at the right point. A shot going wide. And the Brahma's disorganized for the moment. And finally, a good play by Culleton. Just loops it, high fly ball into the Austin territory.
Looks like a German bakery out there for the Brahma's. Turnovers everywhere.
Brahma's have five men back. They didn't even try an attempted forecheck on that. They're playing more of a defensive style here against Austin. Here's the play now into the corner. Not one player in the forecheck on that last rush for Austin. Here's Tolaire, tries to center one. Broken up of the Fort Worth defense. Davis hacking at an ice bat forward. They fight for it ferociously to the side of the goal.
Big unit out for Austin now. STP, Sagan, Tolaire, and Price. They're going to get all kinds of chances. Brahma's do a good job defending him.
Here's Culleton moving in. Centers blocked off of the defense. And clearing it free is Brown at center. Left wing side, Tolaire into the Fort Worth zone. Centers across, off the stick, I believe, of Tilson. Up into the... back behind the goal.
Good play by Mike Tilson going down low. That's a dangerous two-on-one. Tolaire leading the rush left side. Tried to throw it across to Sagan coming down the right side. And we'll take a look at it here on the replay. There's Culleton trying to get back in the play. Tilson goes down, and it didn't hit a stick, Mike. He threw the big glove up there. Looked like Cooper and Ned. It went right off his glove, went high over the glass. That's why Mike Tilson's an all-star.
Face-off will be to the right of the goal. Actually, believe it or not, Tilson is the longest tenured Brahma, and he's only in his third year for Fort Worth.
Yeah, he's when you think Brahmas, you think Mike Tilson. If you can get past that ugly blonde hair, I think you're okay.
Well, I'll let you tell him that personally then. Here's
no
play
problem.
At center ice, Gerald Tolaire able to clear it right back in. I think his wife likes it though, doesn't she?
Yeah, I think she's kind of bothered.
All right, that's good. Here's Tilson to the right wing side, tries to work it free on the near side for Sean Hughes. Hughes for Campbell, the former Tulsa Oiler. Left wing pass for Craig Johnson. Johnson moves hard in across that line into the corner. Johnson center, stays on his feet, gets it to Campbell, drops it for Dan Villeneuve as the Brahmins maintain possession. Campbell tries to center one, loose now back of the goal. Peter Campbell does center one, the net dislodged this time into the Austin zone as the Brahmins with Campbell up front. Hughes and Johnson creating havoc in the Austin territory as the net dislodged into the Austin side of the ring.
Okay,
the score, no score here from the convention center, and we'll be right back with more. This is Fort Worth Brahmins Hockey.
Now the first thing you've got to do is jump up here and scream and yell, woo! Now when somebody hands you one of these babies, make sure you say thank you.
Thank you.
Oh man, don't eat the check.
Want to be like Jeff Gordon? Drive the Chevy Monte Carlo. The cars more champions depend on. Chevy will be there.
Get to your local participating Chevy dealer and enter for your chance to win a 2002 Special Edition Monte Carlo SS.
You know what people are saying about you guys? That you're a bunch of vicious animals. You and I know that's not true. You and I know that this is a game of skill and precision and speed and grace. So I want you to go out there tonight and show them what Fort Worth Brahmins hockey is really about. Okay, you can open the cage now.
One of the best crowds in the history of the Brahmins franchise. They got the big orange ball, Jeff, and they're loving things here tonight. A family atmosphere, huge crowd tonight. And you can take a look from the wide view. There are tons of fans here this evening.
3-hour party tonight at the convention center. These guys are having a lot of fun. Let's hope the team in black gets her going a little bit.
Here are the Bats in their own zone. They clear it right back into the Fort Worth territory. This should be an icing call against Austin. Bork after icing is the infraction. And the faceoff will come all the way back deep into Austin territory. No score, 7:04 left in the opening period. You can take a look at the Fort Worth players bench, and if we can get a tight shot there of Todd Lalonde, and there he is, Allie Davis, the only female trainer in the league, but Todd Lalonde, what a great job, former coach of the year in the Western Professional Hockey League.
Yeah, Todd is just one of the young coaches that is probably the best in pro hockey, not in the National Hockey League. He's got great energy, he's an intense young man. He gets players to play with extreme confidence.
Here's Willard, shoots, and a save made by McMullen. Willard in tight, but McMullen stood his ground and was able to get a piece of it and cleared to center.
Great setup by Schumrich there for Woolard. And Woolard, he's been on a roll lately for the Brahmas. 5 goals, 4 assists in his last 5 and just missed on that one.
Here's Bork, clears it right back in. Culleton in after it. Lardner checked by the Brahmas. Woolard in a stoppage play, and finally, a power play, believe it or not, Jeff, for the Brahmas.
Yeah, Lardner's going to go for hooking, and that's what Chad Woolard gives you. He's 6'2", 205 pounds. He plays with a bit of an uneven disposition. He wins a lot of battles along the wall. And right there, he just out-muscled Tab Lardner, forced Lardner to pull him down, and he earned the power play for the Brahmas. Great shift for Woolard. Started out with a scoring chance, then he comes out and earns the penalty.
And let's take a look at that upcoming. Chad Woolard forcing the Austin player into the call.
Yeah, you'll see, actually, Woolard was able to step up and intercept the pass from the defenseman, and he's just a bigger man. He got in front of the Austin player. Positionally, he was in a better opportunity, and the ice bats player, Lardner, was forced to pull him down. Brahmas on the man advantage.
Hooking at 13-23, Fort Worth in the power play, 46 for 253, 18%. 8th in the league in that department. The Ice Bats 10th in the league at an 80% clip on the penalty kill. And the Brahmas, Culleton gains possession. Brahmas shut out last night. They were shut out 3-0 against the Bossier Shreveport Mudbugs. They've not scored a goal at home in 3 periods plus. Here's the puck loose at center ice, and Greenlaw backhands it deep into the Fort Worth zone. And the Ice Bats are turning it on the Brahmas. The Brahmas succeeded just clearing it down.
Yeah, penalty kill. These are two good hockey teams, two pretty good defensive hockey teams. They know how to play shorthanded. So it's going to be a matter of the Brahmas have to get in, set up, and then create scoring chances. There's not going to get a lot off the rush against this Ice Bat squad.
Yeah, immediately, just like the Brahmas, the Ice Bats are clearing the zone immediately upon gaining possession in their own territory. Brahmas clear it right back in, and on defense, Daryl MacArthur, a youngster. He's a rookie in this league. Plays it free to the left-wing side. Brahmas sent 3 men in and finally gained possession of the near corner. Back to the right-wing point. Culleton shoots, deflected in front, nobody home. Rebound, Clark takes a whack, and loop-de-doo, it goes up into the crowd. The Brahmas with some good puck possession in the offensive territory, and that might sting a little bit when that puck goes up into the crowd, and he doesn't seem too hurt on that.
He'll come back. He's a hockey player, man. He'll score for a few stitches, he'll be back out, no worries.
Right. Looks easier, though, from here than when you're down there. It looks, oh, yeah, I'll just catch that puck, and then it stings a little bit.
Are you kidding me? I'd probably be diving under the sea.
Yeah, you would. And there it is, the lucky spectator here gets his souvenir. The Fort Worth Convention Center, and right off the bat, the Ice Bats clear it deep into the Fort Worth zone, 40 seconds left in the man advantage.
Justin Cargo leading the Brahmas in power play goals this year with 9. He's not in the lineup tonight, so someone's gonna have to step up and fill that void for Fort Worth on the special teams.
Brahmas in circle deep on the left wing side. Fort Worth's forward now back of the net, trying to make a play, and that's Chad Woolard. Woolard now angles back free to the left wing point for Van Volsen. Plays to the side of the goal. Van Volsen centers one. And
what a save
gets
by McMullen.
A piece by that.
Hughes all alone down low. Great centering pass by Chad Woolard. And Hughes, if he had a chance to do that again, he would have got it up. But McMullen was able to slide over, make the pad save on Hughes.
Here's a play at center ice. Brahmas trying to make a play. Stolen by Austin and back the other way. Bobby Brown, a wrist shot. Cooper the save. Rebound. Cooper stops the second player. Ian Malak on the rebound.
Bobby Brown had great speed coming up that left side. The first opportunity, Cooper did a good job coming out of the crease and cutting off Brown's angle. Just kind of swallowed that puck up, but it hit him right off the chest. We'll see it here on the replay. Brown with a hard slap shot right off Cooper's chest. The rebound sat right in front of Van Volsen. Did a good job tying up Brown. LaRock got to it there on his back end. And Cooper, you'll see him kind of be big there. He was down on his back end, but he was able to raise his shoulders up and swallow that rebound off of LaRock's stick. And that's sweet for Corey Cooper. He and Ian LaRock teammates a few years ago with the Waco Wizards.
Here's Willers now in front. Shoots high over top of the goal. Break for Fort Worth. Greg Willers missed the target by a mile. Here's Dan Price back of the goal. Backhander, he also missed. Good breaks for the Brahmas. 2 consecutive misses for the Austin Ice Bats as the Brahmas clear it down.
And it all comes off an offensive zone faceoff win for the Ice Bats. Dan Price is going to get his chances. The Brahmas going to have to do a good job containing him. He got far too much open space in the last opportunity.
Brahmas again send 3 men off the forwards back to check. Here's Tolaire, centers in front, a chance for Price, he scores! What a setup! Price was all alone, unmolested. Austin in the slot. Tolaire centers it, and it's 1-0 Austin.
Yeah, the play started at the blue line when Tolaire was able to get around Dan Villeneuve, and then on his back end, just a centering pass to Price. Price all alone between the circles. We'll check the replay out here. You'll see Tolaire up the right side on his back end. You see him take a peek behind his shoulder, centering pass. There's Price all alone. And for Dan Price, he's second overall in the CHL in goals, and he just added his 41st of the season. And, you know, you can't really fault Corey Cooper on that one. If you give Dan Price that many scoring chances, he's going to capitalize. You'll see Cooper go down early, and Price really had the whole net to shoot at.
Yeah, it's no chance there. Again, all alone in front. He tried to stay with him, but he was able to get it into that far side. 1-0. The assists on that goal for the Ice Bats, Gaffney and Tolaire. Price is 41st of the year, 16:03, and a 1-0 Austin lead. So now the Ice Bats again trying to make a play. Quick shot by Brown off the backboards and wide. And then finally the net dislodged with 3:39 to go in the first period. And the Ice Bats with a 1-0 lead. We'll come back with more from the Convention Center. Central Hockey League action, the Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats 1-0 now in favor of Austin.
Yeah.
Psst, Howie, don't miss the
I swear I heard Terry.
Yes, Howie, you clearly heard Terry. Now get a clear digital Sprint PCS phone by Samsung. The N200 is just $99.99 after a $50 Sprint PCS mail-in rebate. Then, save another $50 only at Radio Shack. Get 4,000 clear wireless minutes for only $39.99 a month.
I just love it when I get into his head.
Howie!
The Sprint Store at Radio Shack.
Hi, I just want to make a deposit.
Do you have your account number?
Right here.
Lean forward, please.
What is this?
It's our new customer tracking system. It has your account number and barcode. It speeds you right through the line.
Now what?
That line over there.
Feel like banks are getting a bit impersonal? Try Washington Mutual. We're building our bank around you because we never forget it's your money.
It's a holdup.
I hate it when these things don't scan.
Washington Mutual.
Brahmas trail the Ice Bats 1-0. Let's take a look at some of the upcoming games for the Fort Worth Brahmas as they conclude down the stretch here. We'll take a look in just a second. We'll get to that in just a moment. 1-0 Ice Bats, 3:38 to go in the opening frame, and immediately it's clear to center ice.
Fort Worth with a good start to this period. They killed off the Ice Bats power play, but the last couple minutes they've kind of been on their heels. They've given Austin some good scoring chances, and Price capitalized moments ago. The Brahmas need a good shift here to get momentum back.
Here's a chance for Brown again. Cooper, the save. And it's like he's a stranger for shots on goal. Nearly 1,800 this season in terms of the shots against. Here's a play now in the slot. Greenlaw misses for the moment. Clear right back to center ice. Culleton is too well tied up. Chance for the Ice Bats. Working free is Tetro. His shot is blocked and the Brahmas control. 2:55 left first period. Three-man break for Fort Worth if they hurry. Van Volsen holds up at the blue line, tries to work it free, but he's poke checked at the last moment. Had he been able to elude that poke check, he might have been able to get to a pass in front. Here's Davis now. Dumps it right back in. The Brahmas change on the fly.
We're seeing the forward defenseman, Tilson Davis, trying to jump into the play and create a little bit of offense there. We'll see that continue out throughout the course of the hockey game.
Other than that, everybody is hustling back to play defense. Here's a play to the far corner, now to the opposite side. Price, who scored that lone goal, hands it free for Brown. The Ice Bats working it free in the slot. Maraca's shot caught. Actually, Sagan, excuse me on that one, with a wrist shot, and Cooper says no. Let's take a look at the upcoming games here for the Fort Worth Brahmas. As Todd Lalonde, a little miffed about all that. This Tuesday at the Convention Center, the Memphis River Kings, the leading team in the Northern Conference. And then next weekend, Jeff, the final two games of the year, the Ice Rays and the Austin Ice Bats to conclude the regular season. Tickets available at all Star Tickets and Albertsons, or at all Metroplex Albertsons locations.
Should be a great weekend for hockey here at the Fort Worth Convention Center. The 15th against Corpus is a must win for the Brahmas. The Ice Rays a little bit lower in the standings than they have been in years past. The Brahmas really need to pick up 2 points. And then next Saturday night, we'll do it again here against the Austin Ice Bats, fan appreciation night. So get your tickets early for that one. Should be another good hockey game between these two hockey teams on display tonight.
And then should the Brahmas hook into postseason play, they'll have a game at home either March 22nd or March 23rd against the Oklahoma City Blazers or the Memphis River Kings. but they have to make the playoffs first. So obviously tonight's game, very important in their quest to gain postseason play. A delayed penalty coming up against Fort Worth. Ice Bats clear it in as soon as Villeneuve touches it. A stop, and now we have a scrap on the far boards. Eric LaBelle and a Fort Worth player hooked up along the far side.
That's LaBelle and Johnson along the side there. Johnson's got the delayed penalty. LaBelle came in, dropped the glove. Now here we go. This is a good one. The linesmen are in between Johnson and LaBelle. Now Johnson comes with a hard right. That'll clear your sinuses, Eric LaBelle. The linesmen, Brian Bull and Doug Whitty, staying between those two combatants. And Mike, keep your eye on these guys. They might want to try to do it again a little later on.
Yeah, the linesmen were able to get in there pretty quickly. It all started along the far boards. Johnson, the veteran, the captain of the Fort Worth Brahmas, LaBelle, the youngster. He's only 21 years of age from Hull, Quebec, taking on the longtime professional veteran at 30 years of age, Craig Johnson.
And you see LaBelle as he's being led off the ice there. He's kind of motioning to Johnson. Hey, let's do it again in a few minutes. I don't think Eric LaBelle wants to do that. Craig Johnson, 6'4", 235. Even on his best days, when he's in the best moods, he's a little bit of a surly, he's a little surly guy. But I think LaBelle's gonna want to keep his nose clean of Craig Johnson, but that would be a good show for the fans if the big captain got one going.
Yep, and the Austin players looking on, they're sorting it out at the penalty box. Should be major penalties for fighting at 18:06. Johnson left the ice at the with less than 5 minutes to go in this opening period. And there may be an extra penalty. It looked like an elbow call, so we may see an additional. I think the Brahmas were going to be penalized to start. Austin was going to have a power play anyway, and I think this will not only be matching major penalties, but we should have a power play opportunity for Austin, depending on how that scrap started along the far side.
Well, Johnson got the initial minor behind the play. I believe it was an elbow up high on the Bats defenseman there. But then LaBelle, if Dwyer administers his penalty correctly, LaBelle should get an additional minor as an instigator. And if I'm not mistaken, LaBelle's going to get an instigator, a major, and a game, should they rule that way, because the instigator carries an automatic game. We'll see if that cancels out the penalties. But let's wait and see how Dwyer administers it.
Jeff Greenlaw, again, a former NHL first-round draft pick by the Washington Capitals way back in 1986 with the young referee, Gordy Dwyer. These guys have a lot of experience, and some young referees in this league, they'll try and talk them into anything.
Yeah,
but we'll see what happens here.
Greenlaw's been playing hockey since Christ wore moccasins, and Dwyer is he's old enough, he can count the hairs on his face in one hand, so a little bit of a discrepancy in experience, but Dwyer seems pretty confident out there, and he handles Greenlaw, tells Greenlaw to beat it, and administers the situation.
So there goes LaBelle too, so we'll again see what these penalties all are about here in just a moment. Looks like that instigation penalty, because there's 2 minutes on the board for Austin.
Yeah, they gave Johnson the original minor, 2 for elbowing and a 5 for fighting. And as I suspected, LaBelle, 2 for instigation, 5 for fighting, the automatic game misconduct. So, you like LaBelle's heart and what his intentions are, but right there he needs to be a little bit smarter. If he wants to go after Johnson, wait and do it at a better time, a more appropriate time, because he got the automatic game misconduct for the instigator to even things up, took his team off the power play.
Brent Hughes, 35 years of age, an intense coach also. We talked about Todd Lalonde. This guy played in the NHL for a long time. In fact, 12 seasons in the National Hockey League. 357 NHL games, Boston, Buffalo, and the Islanders. And he is an intense young man as well.
Yeah, Hughes is a physical player. That's what he was known for during his pro hockey career, was the rough stuff. He spent a little time in the penalty box. And what his argument there is, he doesn't want the instigator on LaBelle. He would prefer to take the major and that's it, cancel it out. But let's watch here how it started. Behind the play, you'll see Johnson move up on the check, and I believe he leads high with his elbow. And there's Johnson going way up high, and that's a justified penalty. Johnson went hard after Gaffney. That kind of touched off the whole thing, and then LaBelle over to challenge Johnson got the instigator. So a fortunate break for the Brahmas. They'll take that all night long.
Here's the play now on the far side. Brahmas cleared that out. The Ice Bats in an even strength situation. Shot from the right point to flex wide as Perriard let it fly. The Brahmas take over on left wing, and it's a two-line pass from inside the Fort Worth blue line to the Austin side of center ice with a minute and a half left in this period. Gerald Tallaire played for Todd Lalonde with the Central Texas Stampede.
Yeah, Gerald Tallaire for the Stampede a couple years back, 99-2000, had 94 points. That's a career high for Gerald. So Todd's very familiar with Tallaire's capability. He's got great speed, good hands, and you saw it early on with the first assist by Tallaire. So the Bombers are going to have to control him. He's a big part of that SPP line for Austin.
Believe it or not, hockey in Texas. There was a team called the Central Texas Stampede in Belton, Killeen, and Temple, Jeff.
Yeah, know a little bit about them. We'll talk about that later. Trying to turn the page.
Here's the play along the near side. It just shows there has been a lot of activity the last few years in addition to the Dallas Stars in the National Hockey League and teams sprinkling throughout the state. There's now a new team in our league in Laredo, believe it or not, the Laredo Bucks next season. Here's play now into the corner. Brahma's in this 1-0 game with the Ice Bats leading late in period one. Kava swings it to the left wing side and the Ice Bats clear it right back into the Fort Worth territory. Cooper himself plays right side. Here comes Clark, dishing it off for Kava. Kava stays in the blue line, centers for Clark, he shoots. Block of the defense, Tilson covers up. Clark now tries to jam it loose and the puck cleared into the corner. The net dislodged and Tilson having some words with an Ice Bat player. Villeneuve in there too, and the line's been trying to separate. And a lot of glove sandwiches there as Dan Villeneuve and Jason Clark in the middle of it into the Austin territory.
Yeah, this game's had a physical tone early on. Both teams not shying away from any contact. And Tilson getting into it behind the play with an Ice Bats player. Villeneuve quick to get over and defend his teammate. Not that Mike Tilson needs it, but then Jason Clark going eyeball to eyeball with Perriard. And we'll keep an eye on those two as the game progresses. Clark, no stranger to the rough stuff. All-time leading penalty minute getter in the East Coast Hockey League. 2,246 minutes in his ECHL career. This year he's leading the Brahmas with 301 penalty minutes. Probably gonna pick up a couple more before the night's over.
With no strangers, as mentioned, to the penalty box, and more infractions right now as the Ice Bats players look on. And Jason Clark says, what the heck's going on here? I'm a little fatigued from all that.
Yeah, Clark's catching his breath. Clark, what he's doing there, he's trying to give his team a spark. Villeneuve trying to give his team some energy. That's part of the physical element of the game, the enthusiasm and energy that a player with Clark's aggressiveness brings to the team cannot be devalued at all. I mean, when he goes over there and he gets in Perriard's face and he's staring him down and he's snarling and he's growling. I mean, me up here in the box, I'm flying all over the place. Imagine what it does for the guys on the ice.
Yeah, and what goes on here in the press box if you're snarling and all that too. But man, I'll tell you what, it is getting intense on the ice so far. And this is what it's all about. There is hockey here in Fort Worth, Texas. Fort Worth Brahmas games next weekend here at the Convention Center. And you want to see all this, you got to see it in person. Next weekend, Fan Appreciation Night next Saturday night against the same Austin team. There'll be penalties here against Tilson for Fort Worth and Greenlaw for the Ice Bats.
Those were the two players originally involved in an altercation, so henceforth they get the minor penalties.
19:40 the time, so they'll finish out 4-on-4, and this will go on into the next period as the Brahmas play to center. Chance for Van Volsen out of his reach. He caught that pass. He would have had a clear-cut breakaway, and the Ice Bats control. 12 seconds to go in the frame. In across the line, Tetro centers across in front. The save by Cooper, rebound. 4 seconds left, a dangerous scoring chance. Had that one gone in, the Brahmas would have been down by 2, starting period number 2.
4-on-4 hockey, lots of open ice, and when you give a team with Austin's talent that kind of space, they're gonna get some opportunities, and right there was Bobby Brown between the circles. Cooper struggled a little bit with that rebound. It went out between the circles. Fortunately, the net was knocked off the moorings behind him. There's Tetro coming on the left side. Good feathery drop pass back to Brown, and Brown, when he gets it, he knows what to do with it, and he got it on net. Cooper made a save. That's 13 saves on 14 shots for Cooper. He's been good early for the Brahmas.
Faceoff will be Lardner against the Brahmas. Campbell, Brahmas win it. That's going to do it. The period has concluded. We're through 20 minutes here, and Jeff, pretty exciting here. The Brahmas, although outshot, some good scoring opportunities, and against this dangerous Ice Bat team, trail only 1-0.
Fort Worth has to be happy with the first 20 minutes of play. Obviously, Lalonde's not too excited to go in down a goal, but they came out early. They took the hockey game to the Austin Ice Bats, got some good scoring chances. McMullen was large for Ice Bats in net, made some big saves. Austin kind of turned the tide, got the goal on by Price, but Fort Worth came back strong. They had a few good shifts after, and they got to feel good about themselves as they go to the dressing room.
Okay, it's 1-0. Bats after 1. We'll have more between periods. including an interview with the Brahmas head coach, Todd Lalonde. 1-0 Bats after one. You're watching Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey.
Here at Town & Country Furniture, we want to invite you to get on the big savings on quality furniture at poor boy prices. I mean poor boy prices. Folks, I've got dining rooms for $199. Sofa love seats for $299. Curios, bunk beds, whatever your furniture need is, I have it. Buy here, save here. Let me earn your business the old-fashioned way. Get in on the poor boy sale. Town & Country Furniture, 305 Carrier Parkway, Grand Prairie.
Today we're going to be doing some real home cooking. Main course is...
Brick!
From my very own home, in fact. And we'll just give it a taste. Bit stiff. Boost the heat a little bit.
For real home cooking taste, come in during Sonic's Home Cooking Month. Sonic's the only place to get the down-home flavor of our new country fried steak toaster sandwich. Try one today, or any of our other toaster sandwiches.
Next, spackle casserole.
Get any large drink in our new car cup in any flavor you can dream of, now just 99 cents.
Everybody, Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey. Tonight, the Fort Worth Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats were between periods. The Fort Worth Hockey Club, and again, the rivals from right down south, those Ice Bats. I'm Mike Barrack, general manager of the Brahmas, also acting as play-by-play voice tonight. With me is the head coach of the Fort Worth Brahmas, the director of hockey operations, the man that makes it happen on the ice, Todd Lalonde. Todd, congratulations. What a turnaround from a Fort Worth team that failed to make the playoffs in the last couple of years. Now the team's fighting for its playoff chances right here down the stretch.
Yeah, we've really played well of late. I think the team's really come around, not only on the ice, but I think off the ice have bought into a real simple system, one that rewards hard work, one that rewards dedication. And we've proven the fact that, again, if we come in and outwork our opponent, we're going to win a lot more games than we lose.
And the Brahmas have played so competitive this year, went through a six-game winning streak of late, and really gave yourself a little bit of breathing room, but not complete yet.
No, it certainly isn't. We still need two more wins over the next five games to guarantee ourselves a playoff spot. But more important than that, rather than schedule watch, we just want to make sure that our team plays sound, both technically and tactically. We're comfortable with our environment here at the Fort Worth Convention Center. We're comfortable with our team and our teammates, and we're really looking forward to it. I mean, again, each night's certainly an adventure in minor pro hockey. You never know exactly what you're going to get from the personnel in the locker room, but importantly, I think we're going in the right direction. Guys are upbeat, their spirits are good, and again, we don't want to live and die in every loss, but it's important we bang off a couple wins here in a hurry.
Well, for the Fort Worth fans who have followed the situation, hockey going back in the years, big action during this past off season, an affiliation with the Dallas Stars. I know you're hoping to get Jeff Bateman back here in the next week or so as the Brahmas try to clinch a playoff spot.
Yeah, there's no question. I mean, Jeff Bateman's a great quality young prospect, not only for the Stars, but he's an immediate impact player for us at this level. And Batesy's played probably 25 or 26 games for us and really been a key cog for us. And I know Dallas is excited with that. Obviously, young players that come into this environment that are counted on to not only produce offensively, but also to produce defensively is the environment that they want them in. And what's great for our program is he's come down here, he's contributed, and he's also made the adjustment at the American League level and has been able to play. So I think it bodes well not only for the Stars in selecting a player like Jeff Bateman, but also bodes well for the Brahmas that they've been able to develop one of their prospects to give him a legitimate opportunity to play.
Todd, talk to us a little bit for the fans watching for the first time Central Hockey League action tonight. What kind of brand of hockey, how would you describe it for the fans watching tonight?
Well, I think it's fast, exciting, exciting, it's honest, and it's really upfront. I mean, when you get to major league sports level, contrary to whatever they're selling, you're really you're distanced from the sport. I mean, they're tough to get to hold of, they're tough to touch. It's a superstar game. The stars play, the stars are marketed, and I think when you come to a minor league hockey game, you're right on top of them. You get to touch the players, you get to see their faces, see their reactions. They live and die on every win and loss, every face-off, every fight situation that may develop. And I don't just mean fisticuff fight, but every battle for a puck. And these kids really do want to go on. They yearn to really make it to the big time, as the cliche goes. And you really see an honest, competitive hockey game each and every night. And I think that's what sells at the minor league level. I mean, these guys really do believe in their hearts that given an opportunity, they can play. And again, not always the best players play in the National Hockey League. So there's some pretty good players that compete in the Central League.
You know, we talk about players advancing on to the National Hockey League and higher levels, but coaches do too. And Todd, when the fans are watching Todd Lalonde behind the bench, my gosh, you give everything to gaining a victory. Talk a little bit about the Todd Lalonde style behind the bench.
Well, I've always been a big believer in the way I've been brought up, is that as a leader, I think you've got to lead by example. And if you ask your players to lay it all on the line each and every night, I think as a coach, you've got to be prepared, again, both technically and tactically. Know exactly what you want of your players and how you want them to play. But above that, I think I'm just an emotional guy. I mean, I want our team to play emotional. I want us to expose ourselves each and every night and not leave anything left. It's tough when you lose a hockey game, you've got a little bit of gas left. I don't think you've given your team the best opportunity. And sometimes I cross the line, I do some things I'm not particularly proud of after I do them, but it's all in the event of winning. I just want to make sure we give our team the best opportunity to win. I want our players to learn that there's nothing that supplements a quality work ethic. And if you work hard for a little bit longer than your opponent, you're going to win the hockey game.
One final short question. Tonight, a short bench, fewer players. There's an opportunity for 18 players in the roster. You have about 13 skaters tonight. Tell us about your bench this evening.
Well, you know what? It's nothing new. We've got 13 players, 13 skaters, two goaltenders, which is far below the normal average, but we've done it all year long. Again, if we're looking for reasons why we can't win the game, we could probably find 100 of them. Unfortunately, we've got a lot more reasons why we want to win, and we've done it all year long. Again, it allows our key players to really expose themselves to their opponent. And again, I'm looking for a tremendous effort tonight and a big win at home.
Well, Todd, congratulations on your great year. For the Brahma fans, perhaps a playoff spot just around the corner, and best of luck tonight and for the rest of the season to you.
Thanks very much, Mike. I appreciate it.
Todd Lalonde, head coach, director of hockey operations for the Fort Worth Brahmas. More Brahmas action in just a moment here at the Convention Center, the Fort Worth Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats.
It's the grand opening of the all-new Galaxy Furniture Warehouse with out-of-this-world prices throughout the store. Living room group, 7 pieces, $2.99. Dining room starting at $129. And bedroom suite starting at $388 for 5 pieces. Special financing and Visa, MasterCard, and Discover accepted.
Save at both locations.
The Galaxy Furniture Warehouse Grand Opening Sale. 950 Big Town Shopping Center, Mesquite, and 2424 South Buckner Boulevard, Dallas.
All that glitters is gold. It shines through in every one of our dependable, long-lasting Chevy trucks. It's Truck Month. Now get 0% APR on any Chevy Silverado. Or get $2,002 cash back on a Silverado regular cab. That's 0% APR on all new Silverados or $2,002 cash back on Silverado regular cab. Only offers this good on trucks this durable. Get the gold bow tie. It's Truck Month. See your Texas Chevy dealer now.
You know what people are saying about you guys? That you're a bunch of vicious animals. Well, you and I know that's not true. You and I know that this is a game of skill and precision and speed and grace. So I want you to go out there tonight and show them what Fort Worth Brahmas hockey is really about. Okay, you can open the cage now.
Another Shaqcessory story.
For years, people have looked for hard-to-find batteries everywhere, from drugstores to grocery stores. But people in the know the place is Radio Shack. Get your hard-to-find batteries for your electronics, no matter where you bought them, from camcorders to cordless phones. Even cordless shavers. Right, Ving? I'll demonstrate.
Radio Shack has hard-to-find batteries for thousands of products.
Did she finish?
Radio Shack.
To the Fort Worth Convention Center.
Center we go. It's Fort Worth Brahmas hockey tonight. The Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats, 1-0 Bats after one. Welcome back, everybody. Mike Barrick alongside Jeff Barman. Jeff, we're having a lot of fun up here. It's unfortunate for the Brahmas down 1-0, but we sure have a lot of excitement here tonight.
Great crowd tonight. Great atmosphere in the Fort Worth Convention Center. And the Fort Worth Brahmas are really feeding off the energy of this crowd. They came out with a great start all over the Ice Bats. Got some good scoring chances early, but it was Austin that got on the board with the only first period goal, courtesy of Dan Price. And he's got a few this year. It was his 41st of the season. So the Brahmas down 1-0. They're going to need a strong second to get back in this one.
Let's take a look at that scoring play in the opening period. Just one goal, and it was a great setup in front of Fort Worth goaltender Corey Cooper.
Here comes the Ice Bats goal, and you see him get the pass out of the zone. They came to Tulare's stick. It was a 2-on-1 for Tulare. He was able to work past Villanova on the blue line up the right side. Stumbled, nearly lost his balance on his back end. Nice saucer pass to Price between the circles. Got Cooper to commit early and went across Cooper's body. And Dan Price, like I said, that's his 41st goal this season. He was second in the league in scoring coming in. That's too easy for Dan Price, and the Brahmas will definitely want that one back.
Then the Brahmas in the offensive zone had some scoring opportunities of their own, just 6 shots on goal, and this is one of their chances.
Yeah, you'll see down low was Cav on the left side. He was able to center through the crease. Hughes all alone on that right side. Didn't get it up like he wanted to, and McCollum was able to make the pad save. It all started, he shot from the point. By 3 hours, a little interstate called I-35, and there's no love lost between the Brahmas and the Bats.
And of course, the Brahmas here in the first period in this scoring play, down 1-0 here at the Fort Worth Convention Center. A lot of excitement, as we talked about, one of the largest, if not the largest. We'll find out as the night progresses, but I'll tell you what, the fans are getting their money's worth. A lot of entertainment on the ice and off the ice.
There's all kind of things going on. We saw big orange balls floating through the convention center. We got the Hooters Dance for Your Dinner, got the Coors Light prize back. It's a 3-hour party. I'm just happy to be here. I'm loving it just like the fans. And the Brahmas, look for them to feed off the energy of this big crowd.
Yeah, Fort Worth right now in the playoff hunt. A victory tonight could assure them pretty much of postseason play. A loss tonight, man, it's going to be hairy down the stretch. They have things on the ice, the Chevrolet Scoro, you see the Albertson Zamboni, the Mansfield Golf Blimp. Oh my gosh, a little bit of everything here tonight.
Yeah, we got a little YMCA. I'm surprised you're not turning around doing it. Well, your wife's over there watching. She's waiting for you to do the YMCA.
She wants me here dancing, but no chance.
I'll dance.
You'll be the dance.
I am not shy at all. Don't worry about that. This is a great environment. You know, if you haven't been out to a Brahmas game, this is what you're missing. Come out, get to see some great hockey players on the ice, be a part of a fun family environment, and it's just a lot of fun. There's nothing else going on. I mean, come out here, hang out with us, have a great time, and watch some hockey.
The next two games, next three games, this Tuesday and next Friday and Saturday night at the Convention Center, 7:05 next Friday night, the Brahmas against the Corpus Christi Ice Rays, and next Saturday night, Fan Appreciation Night against the same Austin team. We'll have more from the Convention Center. 1-0 Ice Bats after one. Hope you're enjoying it. This is Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey.
Attention, Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. Irving Boulevard Furniture is having a store-wide clearance sale. You can save up to 50% on living rooms.
On sale.
Dining rooms.
On sale.
Bedrooms.
On sale.
And mattresses.
On sale.
Hurry, don't delay. Call 972-929-9999. Irving Boulevard Furniture is located at 1500 Irving Boulevard off Loop 12 in Irving, Texas. Just look for the big yellow and red sign.
Hi, I just want to make a deposit.
You have your account number?
Right here.
Lean forward, please.
What is this?
It's our new customer tracking system. It has your account number and barcode. Speeds you right through the line.
Now what?
That line over there.
Feel like banks are getting a bit impersonal? Try Washington Mutual. We're building our bank around you because we never forget it's your money.
What's a holdup?
I hate it when these things don't scan.
Washington Mutual.
Today we're going to be doing some real home cooking. Main course is...
Brick!
Brick! From my very own home, in fact. And we'll just give it a taste. bit stiff. Boost the heat a little bit.
For real home cooking taste, come in during Sonic's Home Cooking Month. Sonic's the only place to get the down-home flavor of our new country fried steak toaster sandwich. Try one today or any of our other toaster sandwiches.
Next, spackle casserole.
Get any large drink in our new car cup in any flavor you can dream of, now just 99 cents.
You see Cooper with 13 saves, McMullen with 6 saves. Power play, Fort Worth killed off a 2-man advantage for the Ice Bats for 22 seconds. Unable to do anything with their only power play, but they had some good puck possession. Key stat there is faceoffs. Fort Worth early winning all of them. Austin came back late, won 16 faceoffs in that first period. That's where the tide started to turn. The faceoff causes puck possession, which leads to scoring chances. And it was a rough first period for Austin, 21 minutes in penalties for the Fort Worth Brahmas, 15. Well, I expect the tendency to keep up there as far as rough stuff goes.
And just one goal in this opening frame. It was Price scoring his 41st of the year, and that on a 2-man break in front of the Fort Worth goal. And that's the only goal here in period number one.
Yeah, Dan Price, he had 2 or 3 chances in a row there, Mike. Cooper made a couple big saves on him early, but when Price was set up with Tulare between the circles, he made Cooper come in early, was able to go across his body. No chance for Coop on that one. But again, the Brahmers are going to need to do a better job on Dan Price, locking him down, knowing where he's at in all areas of the ice. You can't give him time and space because he'll burn you. But so look for the Brahmas to really contend with him over the course of the next 40 minutes.
The Brahmas and the Ice Bats have had a lot of fierce battles the last few years. This nonetheless another battle here in Fort Worth. Let's take a look at the upcoming games for the Fort Worth Brahmas. And next Saturday night is the final game of the year. It's Fan Appreciation Night, also against the Ice Bats. There'll be prizes galore, and I'm sure if anybody's watching the game tonight and see what's going on, be more of the same next Saturday right here, 7:05 at the Fort Worth Convention Center. Tickets available at all Albertsons locations or by calling Star Tickets or by showing up next Saturday night. We got a game Friday night here at the Convention Center as well.
Yeah, it's gonna be a fun weekend. We got Corpus Friday, Austin Saturday. 60 minutes isn't gonna decide the battle between these two teams tonight, so we're gonna do it again next Saturday. Give away all kinds of prizes. Sponsors have chipped in. Ton of great gifts, ton of giveaways for the fans. It should be a lot of fun, and if it's anything like tonight, don't miss it.
What should be great is the Brahmas conclude their 2001-2002 campaign. The score after 20 minutes of play. The Ice Bats won, the Brahmas nothing. We'll come back and take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard as well, the second period of play in just a moment. This is Brahmas Hockey.
It's the grand opening of the all-new Galaxy Furniture Warehouse with out-of-this-world prices throughout the store. Living room group, 7 pieces, $2.99. Dining room starting at $129. And bedroom suite starting at $388 for 5 pieces. Special financing and Visa, MasterCard, and Discover accepted.
Save at both locations.
The Galaxy Furniture Warehouse Grand Opening Sale. 950 Big Town Shopping Center, Mesquite, and 2424 South Buckner Boulevard, Dallas.
Now, the first thing you've got to do is jump up here and scream and yell, woo! Now, when somebody hands you one of these babies, make sure you say thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, man, don't eat the check.
Want to be like Jeff Gordon? Drive the Chevy Monte Carlo, the cars more champions depend on. Chevy will be there.
Get to your local participating Chevy dealer and enter for your chance to win a 2002 Special Edition Monte Carlo SS.
You know what people are saying about you guys? That you're a bunch of vicious animals. Well, you and I know that's not true. You and I know that this is a game of skill and precision and speed and grace. So I want you to go out there tonight and show them what Fort Worth Promise Hockey is really about. Okay, you can open the cage now.
Promise and the Austin Ice Bats. It is a 1-0 score in favor of Austin. Dan Price, the lone goal here tonight. Well, there's a lot of activity in the Central Hockey League. Our Radio Shack CHL Out of Town scoreboard. Tonight, CHL Out of Town scoreboard brought to you by Radio Shack. Radio Shack, you've got questions, we've got answers. The Tulsa Oilers, 5 points behind the Brahmas. Well, 1-1 after one against the Amarillo Rattlers.
I never thought I'd say this, but come on, Amarillo. Tulsa and Amarillo deadlocked after one, and Amarillo's out of it right now. They're trying to play the role of spoiler, tied at one with Tulsa in the first period.
El Paso and Corpus Christi, the Ice Bait Rays out of it. El Paso trying to gain a playoff spot in the West. We'll see.
That's the Billy Davidson game down there. He owns both teams, but El Paso right now fourth overall. They've won a couple in a row to move up in that Southern Conference playoff standings, and that's a big game for both hockey teams.
San Antonio Iguanas. People said hockey in San Antonio and Lubbock, Texas, the home of Bobby Knight. The Cotton Kings trail the Iguanas 1-0 after one. The Memphis River Kings, they're the leaders in the north. And those other pesky guys from Oklahoma City, the Blazers and the River Kings. And then in Odessa, the Jackalopes have been great this year, 1-0 after one.
Odessa's won 10 in a row before losing to Austin last night. They're trying to get back in the winning track here this evening against St. Angelo.
Okay, here we go. Second period. Brahmas trail by one. A quick snap over top of the goal. And the Brahmas trying to work it out of their own zone. 1-0 Bats after one. Early in the second period, Justin away. Willard shoots. Shoulder save. McMullen. Big rebound as the Ice Bats gain possession back of the goal. So the Brahmas starting off strong in the second period. Willard fiercely in a forecheck. Brahmas have not scored in four periods.
Four on four hockey, lots of open ice here. Ice Bats are dangerous with this space here with their speed, but Brahmas answering back early with some good chances. Willard's a man possessed tonight. He's playing unbelievable.
Here's a centering pass, and Price is denied. Brahmas break two men to center. Willard, enveloped the forward Van Volsen, who was tripped down, no call. Todd Lalonde and the Brahmas feeling that Van Volsen was tripped up on the play, and there should have been a power play.
Yeah, that's a tough break for the Brahmas. Van Volsen pulled down from behind, though. I believe it was Sagan that took down Van Volsen just as Van Volsen gained the offensive zone for the Brahmas. But it all started with a great save by Corey Cooper back there for Fort Worth. Price was all alone on the doorstep. Cooper, good save by him. Triggered the break, handed it up to Willard. Willard skated the length of the ice. He had Van Volsen trying to join him on the two-on-one, but after Van Volsen was pulled down, Willard forced to shoot there. He shot high, but this four-on-four, Mike, can't sit down here. It's exciting as Tilson and Greenlaw remain in the box respectively for each team.
Brahmas in their black uniforms here in the second half of the season. In the dark uniforms, Bobby Brown works against Sumrick for Fort Worth. He's a backliner. It's worked into the corner. They try and jam it free to the left wing point. Ice Bats work it free. Tolaire shoots. Kick save by Cooper. At the right point it goes. Perriard shoots. Caught by Cooper. It may have been going wide, but Corey elects to take the safe play anyway, and then a glove sandwich from Sumrick to an Austin player. Don't tell me, Jeff, he's going to get called for that little love tap.
Yeah, David.
No way.
Unhappy with something in front of the net there.
A slap. Oh, it was a push, Jeff.
They had an initial slashing call coming up on Sumrick, and then after the whistle, after Brown went back at Sumrick, Sumrick gave Brown a couple of basically a straight arm right to the face of Bobby Brown, knocked him on his derriere. That earned him I believe an additional penalty as Dwyer made the penalty call, a motion for unsportsmanlike. So we'll see what the call is specifically on David Sumrick. But nonetheless, looks like the Bombers are going to be shorthanded here early on in this second period.
David Sumrick is a 21-year-old from Orillo, Ontario, a rookie out of North Bay and Sudbury of the Ontario Hockey League. And if this is the case, they have 2 minutes on the board for Sumrick, and it will be a power play for the Ice Bats on a 4-on-3.
That extremely rare 4-on-3 power play coming up here is Sumrick got the only minor of that altercation, and now the Brahm is down 1-0. They're shorthanded early on in the second period. This is a big kill for Fort Worth. Fortunately for the Brahm, as Corey Cooper's been great in net, he's seeing the puck all the way. He's confident, he's on top of the crease. Your goaltender has to be your best penalty killer, and we'll see if Cooper can rise to the occasion for the Brahm.
Okay, so a power play is mentioned for the Ice Bats, 4-on-3. They've not yet announced it, but as mentioned, the Brahmas are down. Just that 1 2-minute time on the clock. It's slashing, it appears. And again, at 1:10 in period number two. So the Brahmas will rely on the man, Corey Cooper, in this disadvantage for Fort Worth.
Yeah, number one power play in the Central Hockey League, the Austin Ice Bats going back on the man advantage as Sumer gets called for the slashing penalty. He's going to get an extra minor for unsportsmanlike. We'll see what the official call is. Still starting to straighten it out here in the press box, but nonetheless, Sumrick in the box for the Brahmas. And now the three penalty killers out there for Fort Worth, Cava, Clark, and Villeneuve. The impetus falls on their shoulders to kill this penalty off for the Brahmas.
Todd Lalonde in disbelief over the call. Nonetheless, a power play for the Ice Bats and a tough situation for Fort Worth. Here we go, Brahmas clear to the point outside the blue line and a break for Fort Worth. And Tetro gains possession. And it's Tetro now at the right point between the blue lines. Shoots it wide. The other two players are back on. It's now a 5-on-4 power play for a minute 40. And the Brahmas down 1-0 in this game. Here's Tetro at the point. Plays it free on the opposite wing as the Ice Bats wheel and deal. Chance for Brown to Price, deflected. Cooper says no. Big Dan Price stationed like a rock in front of the goal, causing some havoc. Although Mike Tilson and Jason Clark and Dan Villeneuve are in the vicinity, they still were able to get the shot on goal.
Yeah, it was a shot from the point by Brown for Austin. He just kind of spinned at the top of the circle, waited for Price to set his screen, and he fired. Cooper was able to move over and see around Dan Price, and good job by Mike Tilson to keep Price out of the way. There's Bobby Brown. He's got a hard, heavy shot. He kept it low to the ice surface. Good save by Cooper, and better work by Tilson to keep Price from the rebound. Here we go, a shorthanded chance for the Brahmas coming the other way.
Here's Van Volsen poke checked at the last moment. He tried to sidestep the defenseman, Tetro, who gained possession at the last moment. 1-0 Ice Bats. Austin on the power play. They spank it right back into the Fort Worth zone. Tolaire on the far board. Sagan tied for the lead in scoring in the Central Hockey League. Sagan circling. Hands it free on the far side. Austin wheel and deal with the man advantage. Here's Brown on the far side to Tolaire. Back to Brown at the left point. Fakes his shot. Lost possession for the moment, but fortunately for him, he still gains possession. Shoots one through traffic, and Cooper says no. He was able to finally catch it after it somehow went through a maze of traffic.
Bobby Brown, a one-man power play for the Ice Bats on that left point. And all he's doing is waiting. He's buying time. He's kind of backing off. He's waiting for Dan Price to set up in front and create a screen opportunity for a shot on goal. And there's Price shot from the left side. And Bork pushing Price out of the way, allowed Cooper to see that puck. Good work by Bork in front against Dan Price. And that's what I talked about during the intermission. The Brahmas need to keep a body on Price and know where he is at all times.
Faceoff will be deep into the forward zone. Brahmas still a man short for 50 seconds. This is the fourth power play of the night for Austin. The Brahmas clear. So far, the Brahmas have held the Austin Ice Bats off the scoreboard with the man advantage. Here's the play at center ice. The Ice Bats take control. Gaffney at center is checked. Now it clears it right back into the Fort Worth zone. Laurent able to spin it behind the Fort Worth goal. Greenlawn after it. Played now to center ice, and Culleton picks it opening and clears it down.
One thing to keep your eye on, Wooler just went to the bench for the Brahmas in a great deal of pain. And Allie Davis over to attend to him right away. We'll see if Wooler can come back. Didn't see what happened to him, but I know he's hurting over there.
Brahmas have some key scratches tonight. One, Justin Cardwell out with a concussion. Cody Liable with a kidney injury, and also for Fort Worth, Jeff Bateman remains on recall to the Dallas Stars of the National Hockey League. Expected a return to Fort Worth next week. Here's a clearing shot into the Fort Worth zone. Cooper himself plays outside the blue line to Campbell. A break into the Austin zone. He's in, he shoots high over top of the net. What a brilliant setup from Corey Cooper. What a great pass from this Fort Worth goaltender.
Yeah, Cooper said, boys, let me give you a little help getting on the scoreboard. He sprung Campbell up that left side, and Campbell just missed it, high glove side. Another opportunity for Fort Worth. They tried to go high on Brian McMullen, and Corey Cooper created the offensive opportunity there for the Brahmas.
It was a great scoring chance for Fort Worth. The Brahmas have yet to solve this 24-year-old from East Amherst, New York, and it was Corey Cooper to Campbell breaking down the left wing side.
Yeah, Campbell's got a huge shot all alone top of the circle. He labeled it up high glove, unfortunately just missed over that far corner.
I'll tell you what, the fans will explode tonight if the Brahmas score. They've not scored for a couple of games. They did not score last night in their 3-0 loss to this Bossier Shreveport Mudbugs. Here's play to center ice, Austin, clear it in. That's it, the Brahmins killed off that penalty. Teams at even strength. The Brahmins penalty killing has been perfect tonight. Here's a centering pass, Brahmins in the slot. Work out of there. Lead pass to the advancing player at center ice, Van Volsen. Saucers a pass to the left wing side. And Tilson just muscles it behind the ice bat's cage. It's the player Brown. Winds it not out. Tilson holds it in, shoots through traffic, slapped away to the left wing side of the bats, clear at the center.
Tilson shot from the point, and Clark looked like he redirected that one, but McMullen able to fight it off, fend off the play, and make the save.
Okay, 1-0 ice bats after 4:13 into the second period. We'll take a break. You're watching Fort Worth Brahmas Hockey.
Where I heard Terry.
Yes, Howie, you clearly heard Terry. Now get a clear digital Sprint PCS phone by Samsung. The N200 is just $99.99 after a $50 Sprint PCS mail-in rebate. Then, save another $50 only at Radio Shack. Get 4,000 clear wireless minutes for only $39.99 a month.
I just love it when I get into his head. Howie!
The Sprint Store at Radio Shack.
Hi, I just want to make a deposit.
You have your account number?
Right here.
Lean forward.
What is this?
It's our new customer tracking system. It has your account number, barcode. Speeds you right through the line.
Now what?
That line over there.
Feel like banks are getting a bit impersonal? Try Washington Mutual. We're building our bank around you because we never forget it's your money.
It's a hold.
I hate it when these things don't scan.
Washington Mutual.
Well, you can see a little bit of everything for everybody. The cheerleaders enjoying it. 1-0 bats. Hey, Brahma fans, for a limited time only, you can receive two free $13 Brahma tickets, $26 value from Diamond Shamrock with the purchase of two Coca-Cola products, 20-ounce Coca-Cola products. See participating Metroplex locations or log on to Brahmas.com for details. Diamond Shamrock, keeping you on the go. Those tickets will be good for next weekend. The Brahmas and the Austin Ice Bats and the Corpus Christi Ice Rays, the 15th and 16th, and also Tuesday night, the Brahmas and the River Kings here at the Convention Center.
Three home games next week for Fort Worth. It starts off Tuesday night against the Northern Conference leading Memphis River Kings, and the Brahmas have had success against Memphis this year. Should be a good hockey game. Next weekend, back-to-back home games Friday and Saturday to close out the home portion of the Brahmas schedule. First Corpus in town, then Austin is going to come dance again with the Brahmas, so it should be some exciting hockey next weekend coming up here at the Fort Worth Convention Center.
Well, we have exciting hockey tonight. The Brahmas have yet to score a goal. But it's just a 1-0 game, anybody's hockey game early on. Here's play at center ice, and Culleton snaps it right back in, actually up over the runway area, into the curtain back of the goal. It's a horseshoe arena here. They have the curtain as Culleton let it fly, and what an addition for Todd Lalonde. As you see the end zone, it's a horseshoe, an 11,000-seat building here tonight, Jeff. And this building built in the late 60s, early 70s, and they've had hockey going on here from that time.
Really a sparkling facility, the centerpiece of the downtown area in Fort Worth. Great entertainment option for the downtown patrons, and just come down, have dinner, go have a drink, then come over and enjoy some hockey. It's a great setup here in Fort Worth for pro hockey.
And of course, after the game with the Bass Brothers and all the activities downtown for post-game activities as well. Here's a centering pass and deflected away as the player Perriar was in deep for Austin. Plays down back of the goal. They try and work it for Gerald Tolaire as they fight for Aloma boards. 1-0 bats. Tolaire centers, beautifully intercepted by Tilson, who outlets for Campbell, who's too well checked by Tolaire. And the bats control at their own defense and work it outside the blue line.
The best players for Austin, Tolaire and Price playing big for the Ice Bats. There's Tolaire again with a centering pass. Shot fortunately went wide.
And the Brahmas control back of the net. 14:45 left second period. A lead pass on right wing from Tilson. Has Culleton on the move. In across the line. Feeds it for Hughes. It bounces off his stick. But Hughes still gains possession for the moment. Taken out of the play. And the Ice Bats on the left wing side. MacArthur breaks out of there. 1-0 Austin. 14 and a half minutes left in the second period. And they clear it in. So a lot of dumping and chasing, Jeff, on both sides of the ice.
Yeah, Fort Worth, as we said, with just 12 skaters now. Woolard injured for the Brahmas. They're going to play a lot of dump and chase, play a lot of defense over the course of this hockey game, try to be opportunistic offensively.
Yeah, we've not seen Woolard back. He was shaken up here early in this period. We'll see what happens as the night progresses on that situation. And the puck bounces all the way to center. Again, Fort Worth short in numbers anyway. And the Brahmas can ill afford an injury at this particular point of the season as they are trying to clinch a playoff spot. Here's Culleton able to get a piece of it deep into the Austin zone. A foot race for it. Van Volsen does not win the battle against the Austin player, Mike Gaffney. And thus icing on the play. The faceoff will come all the way back. Gaffney, a young defenseman on the back line for the...